Today, I will be doing a review on this one dongle which is highly anticipated coming from Fruitier Shio. Let's check it out. Okay, now let's have a look at the build, the construction, and the configuration of Fruitier Shio. First of all, this is essentially their first ever dongle since they started a few months back, and I believe this is also their third product release since then. And to reflect the highly affordable price at $69.99, basically $70, Shio comes in a very simple package at which you will get just the dongle and a USB type C to C cable, and of course this very beautiful box. Okay, let's just look at the configuration itself. Inside the dongle, there is a dual Cirrus Logic CS43198 with the power rating of 4 VRMS coming from the 4.4 balance port. That is the maximum power. And also, it also has this 3.5mm single-ended, which is capped at 2 VRMS of power. Now, this is interesting. If you look at the screen right now, the configuration, it actually has 4 different split of power at which you can toggle them easily by switching high gain and low gain mode, of which I will show you later how to do that. The signal to noise ratio for this Fruitier Shio is rated at 130 dB, which is quite impressive. And again, going to the power, at the maximum configuration of 4 VRMS with high gain, Shio will deliver 150 milliwatt of power from each channel. Okay, now let's have a look at the configuration itself, the build itself. Just look at that. I'll be very frank with you. This is probably one of the most beautiful dongle that I have seen so far. It is constructed of a very solid aluminium body. But most interestingly is that how they encase it with this leather kind of skin. Now, I'm not sure whether this is true leather or not, but I don't care. It just looks beautiful. Okay. It feels nice to the touch, and it is definitely something to get if you are the type who dislike fingerprints. Fruitier Shio will not attract fingerprint. See? Just marvel at the look here. Okay, enough of that. Let's have a look at the ports and the auxiliary devices, or should I say function available here. Okay, first and foremost, this is the 4.4mm balance port, and this is the 3.5mm balance single-ended. And these are the volume controller. Okay, and I will show you later precisely how do they function. And perhaps I can even show it to you now that by doing this double click here, you can toggle high and low gain mode. And this is, of course, the USB-C. And we also have the here a simple LED window to indicate high and low gain, and perhaps also the resolution. But I haven't tested that yet fully. There you have it. Very simple and yet very beautiful. Again, like I say, just look at that. It's just so very beautiful. Okay, we will now talk about the sound aspect of this Fruitier Shio. I'll just try to make it as concise as possible. This Shio is an amazing unit. Sound-wise, build-wise, pretty much the whole package. Okay, talking about the sound itself. First and foremost, this is a neutral dongle. It is transparent, it is uncolored, and it is very linear with the sound presentation. The balance of sound is amazing, be it for, let's say, something analytical, musical, and engaging. This is something which is what I consider top-tier performance alongside Dongle Madness top performance. Okay, now, talking about the transparency itself. What I mean by transparency is that when I attach any type of IEM or headphone, does not matter whether they are warm, does not matter whether they are analytical, does not matter whether they are bright or let's say musical, with Shio, I am getting faithful sound reproduction as per intended with the designated IEM. So which means that, for example, I use it with Atemotic ER2XR or even Tanjim's Zero. Those are two of my favorite IEMs. What I'm hearing is something which is very neutral sound, does not give any hint of coloration or anything like that. There's no sense of boosted frequency anywhere from upper range to the lower range or even mid range. So that is transparency and I love it. And another aspect of it is that when it comes to the dynamic handling itself, the dynamic range, for once, it is very well extended end to end. So for example, if I were to attach my Shure KSE 1500, which pushes everything to the extreme and from one end to another, I am hearing lots of micro details or whatever details that is available in the recording. So it means that even for TOTL sort of performance, Shio lives up to it. The dynamic presentation is there. And the dynamic handling itself. Okay, let's just make it like this. The vibrancy level, which is exhibited by Shio, truthfully, I would say that it will be kind of a bit like, because it is neutral, it does not exhibit any kind of extra energy, but it is just simply kind of like smooth, relaxed, and truthful to the source. Okay, so what it means is that, right, it is just simply presenting how it was intended by the sound device and also the source. So, and from whichever perspective they're looking at it, this is something which is considered very desirable as well. All right, and then looking at the aspect of the tone, timbre and tonality, I would regard that Shio among one of the few that has that organic touch to it. Not so much, but it is ample enough to instill a good sense of musicality. Okay, which means that despite being somewhat on the technical, or should I say analytical side, Shio exhibited enough element of musicality, organic touch to the sound, to the timbre balance, to make it, to avoid the pitfall of sounding outright digital, bright, or even plasticky. And again, that is a huge plus in my book as well. And now, let's talk about the technical side aspect of it. Okay, technical-wise, this is also a top performer. First, let's talk about the sound stage itself. Let's just put it this way. I have heard many Cirrus Logic DAC amp, and Shio is one of them that offers wide expanse of sound, depending on what type of partner you plug it in into. Even my Atemotic sounded spacious. You know, it is holographic. It is like, say, it does not present to me a sense of being cramped or congested or anything like that. The layering is good. The separation is good. The resolution is good. The handling of micro and macro details are also succinct, meaning that I can hear them clearly. Okay, so that's the technical aspect of it. Also, perhaps maybe still on the technical aspect, it is also very quiet. At 130 dB, you can expect this Shio to perform very silently, even with the most sensitive of IEM. When I attached my C-Audio Bravery, I was like hearing very clean floor noises, very clean background. And when listening to something like a ballad or even jazz or anything like that, it's just so relaxing. All right, now let's talk about features and power. In order to do that, I will bring here my juggernaut here, Hi-Fi Man HE400SE. Okay, this is pretty much one of the most heavy to drive, difficult to drive magnetic planar headphone you can get in the market nowadays. So in order to show you that, I will do a screen recording. First, I just click start here. Okay, it is recording now. You can see on the screen now, right? I attach my Shio. I will skip UAPP first because I will show you Hebe Music. Okay, because this is my primary player. Okay, when Hebe Music start, immediately it will ask me, okay, for USB exclusive mode. I click OK. All right. Now, this is what I want to show you first. Perhaps the only cons that I would highlight for this Shio. When I press this volume here, you notice that the volume on the screen move as well. So what does it mean? It means that Shio does not offer independent volume adjustment. Such a shame, because I have loved everything about this dongle, but when it comes to volume adjustment, I wish that they could have made this independent, but that is not the case. But it's okay. It's just probably, you know, preference, at least for my side, I want it to be independent so that I can have separate volume adjustment from the host. The restriction, or should I say the limitation of this situation, is that because imagine this, if you are playing in non-USB exclusive mode, you play Tidal, you play, let's say, Spotify, you play YouTube Music. So when you actually press this, right, it is 100% dependent on Android volume jump limitation, which is not a nice thing, believe me. You jump from one level to another level with highly sensitive IM, suddenly it becomes too loud or too, you know, low. And so that is why I always prefer independent volume adjustment. Okay, now, how about the power itself? I'll just play one music here, all right? You hear that? Crazy loud. Okay, that was 21. Now, this is my listening volume, yeah, at around 14. You see that? That is just slightly below half, 14 out of 32. This Shio is super powerful, as per is expected out of a 4 VRMS dongle. In fact, this is definitely top tier kind of performance coming from something so small, right? No issue at all driving this Hi-Fi Man HE400 SE. The sound is full, the sound is rich, the sound is engaging. It makes me forget that I will ever need desktop DAC M. That's how powerful it is. Okay, now let's just put that aside. Okay, so that's the sound aspect and the feature of it. Now let's talk about some comparison with the dongles. Okay, for that purpose, I am bringing up this. Okay, on your screen right now, you'll be seeing a table which I have constructed earlier, okay, to help me out with the comparison. You will notice there that, right, the focus, the title says sound characteristic comparison, timbre, temperament, and dynamic transients. Why I'm putting this up? Because these are primarily what makes a difference between one dongle to another, especially when the aspect of sound. Okay. And I'm putting there Centron DeckPouch HD, my number one dongle, okay, because it is my reference. So you notice that Centron DeckPouch HD score 50 to 50% for both crispness and resolution, smoothness and fluidity. What it means is that this is perfect. The balance is just perfect between smoothness, resolution, imaging, and everything. So that is the benchmark. That is why this guy is number one. Okay, where does Trattier Shio falls into the picture? You would notice there on the crispness and resolution, it scores at around 45% of it on the crispness side, and the smoothness on the fluidity, it focuses a bit more by 5%. Okay, and when compared to iBASO DC03 Pro, another of my favorite, okay, it's the other way around. It's as if like you are turning this side and flip it over, and then it become iBASO DC03 Pro. And this is another Cyrus logic as well. Okay, just 43131. The focus for DC03 Pro is a bit more, let's say, on the crispness and resolution, a bit more analytical, and just slightly less on smoothness, fluidity. Does not mean that this thing is rough, but it just more means that this thing focus a bit more with smoothness if were to be compared directly with iBASO DC03 Pro. And just a little bit more a bit on the comparison. In general, I would say that DC03 Pro offers a bit more vibrancy, a bit more energy, and a bit more forwardness to the sound, especially with mid-range. Okay, it feels a lot more engaging to the listener, a bit more colored, simply put. Shio, because it focuses a bit more on being neutral and transparent, does not exhibit that kind of euphonic presentation as compared to DC03 Pro. So that's the primary example that I would say between those two. And obviously, of course, Shio offers double the power of DC03 Pro, among other things. Okay, and next, just focus a bit more on the rest of the Cyrus Logic dongle here. We have Tanjim Space. We have Moondrop Moon River 2. we have X2O linked to balance. So I'll just bring straight up jump to Moon River 2. Okay, make it simple. Between this and Moondrop Moon River 2, if I were to do a blind test, I will be frank with you, I would not be able to tell the difference between this and Moondrop Moon River 2 because both exhibited similar kind of sonic performance in terms mano o mano. They are pretty much, I think my hearing is not advanced enough to be able to tell if there's any difference with the both of them, okay, with Moondrop Moon River 2. However, when compared with Tanjim Space and X2O Link 2 Balance, okay, you would notice that Tanjim Space and X2O Link 2 Balance offer similar kind of number there, 40 to 60 kind of split. So what it means is that X2O Link 2 Balance is just slightly 5% less crispness and resolution, but it offers a bit more on fluidness and smoothness. It also means that Link 2 Balance offer a bit more density to the sound. It sounds a bit thicker, slightly thicker, and this one slightly flatter. Okay, so and perhaps Tanjim Space would be the bridging, let's say, element between Link 2 Balance and Shio, but that difference is very, very small, I would say. It will require quite a bit of intensive side-by-side testing to be able to tell the difference. Okay, so that's pretty much the comparison that I have for this with regard to the rest of the dongle. I hope it is clear enough, right? Let me just stop this recording first. Okay, so let's now just conclude on this Shio. Again, like I say, Shio is a beautiful dongle. For the asking price, this is amazing. The sort of sound performance, the quality, the build, everything is just top-notch. The only caveat that I would bitch, sorry about that, about it, is just that this volume adjustment here. If this were to be independent volume adjustment, it would have been perfect. Okay, so, and another thing, battery consumption of Shio. Be prepared to hear this. This thing runs on my phone here 23 hours non-stop until the phone died. That is crazy efficient. It is more efficient even than my iBASO DC03 Pro, which scores at around 17 hours. Okay, so if you want to travel, you want to conserve your phone battery, use Shio. Definitely your phone will not die anytime soon, even running on high gain 4.4 amp balance port. Crazy good. Okay, so where does Shio stand in the ranking of dongle madness? With all things considered, with the tough competition that we have nowadays with dongles and everything, I have no hesitation to give this a 4.5-star rating. Okay, there you have it. Thank you for tuning into Dongle Madness. Stay tuned for more content from me. Bye.